Bienvenidos a Encuentros con Cineastas en el Aguilar Film Festival. Hoy nos vamos a encontrar con una nueva directora que participa en la sección oficial del Festival de Aguilar de Campó. Vamos a hablar con Catarina Lickqvist. Ahora ella me dirá exactamente cómo hay que pronunciar su apellido, que no lo sé muy bien. Es una directora finlandesa que compite en Aguilar con El Último Torero, de Last Matador. Una historia surrealista, teatral, de animación, que mezcla a un torero inmortal con forma de esqueleto en una Barcelona donde se han prohibido los toros y en el que también aparece Vladimir Putin. Una historia absolutamente surrealista que provoca la risa, pero también la reflexión. How are you, Katarina?
Hello.
Well, first of all, I was saying to people how to pronounce your surname, because probably I didn't do it well.
Lilquist. Actually, it is a Swedish name.
Okay, sorry, because I didn't pronounce it very well.
Yes.
I'm going to ask you a few questions, okay? Well, first of all, the theme of the film is, as usual in your films, because you are a veteran in the European animation, it's international. I mean, it's submitted as a Spanish film, but it's from different countries, isn't it? I mean, you are from Finland.
Finland, Sweden, Czechland, and even from Netherlands.
All right, so it's from different countries. It's really European film. It's a really European film. Básicamente, la película es de distintos países, aunque es producción española, pero ella es finlandesa y luego hay toda una serie de países involucrados ahí. Okay, the next question is, where does this story come from? Because, I mean, it's a very surrealistic mixing, bullfighting and Vladimir Putin. I mean, can you tell me the origin of this story?
Some years ago, I was traveling in Catalonia. I was spending a time in Barcelona a lot. And I heard the stories about the malls, the former arenas that were turned into shopping malls. And I got interested. And then I also heard the stories that many of the Russian oligarchs are having the dachas nearby to Costa Brava. I got even more interested. And then I started to think about the story, because Vladimir Putin has always liked this extreme sports, like flying with the ducks or diving with the sharks. And suddenly I got the idea that he might maybe like also to be a matador.
All right. La historia le vino hace unos años cuando estuvo en Cataluña, estuvo en España y le pareció buena idea en un momento dado mezclar Vladimir Putin con con lo que encontró aquí como el last matador. Vladimir Putin as the last matador. Why he is the last matador?
Well, I think there is something very touching, you know, the art of the bullfighting is gone, and a bit this, how can I say, the portrait of this very masculine sport hero is also a bit like a gun. So I was combining these things, this a bit of the dusty machismo. And,
right.
And I liked very much to think about this symbolic things. And also there is something, how can I say, almost mythological, because when I created the character of Minotaurus, then the film started to be more serious, like an archaic story more than an political animation. So the Minotaurus gave the real twist. I was really excited when I was sending little Putin to meet the Minotaurus.
Bueno, básicamente ella mezcla distintas cosas de un modo simbólico. Le pareció interesante, bueno, la idea esta del estereotipo, ¿no? Del macho, de mezclar por el tipo de persona que es Vladimir Putin. Y además, dentro de esos elementos simbólicos, pues también introduce en la historia un minotauro. Lo que ya digo que crea todo un ambiente completamente surrealista, que es lo que he dicho al principio. I suppose that you designed the puppets, yeah? But do you have a team to make them? How is the process to design those puppets?
I have an international team, Czech and Finnish puppet makers. And actually the process is very much like in the fiction film. We are having the costume designer.
All right.
And then we are even sometimes we are making wigs. And the costume designing is always very precious. We are really doing the costumes by hand. And then we have the painters who are painting the puppet heads. So we have plus minus 5 or 6 professionals in the team. First, we are creating the animation skeleton or armature, as we say it in stop motion slang. And it's a metal skeleton. And then we just start to put things around the skeleton.
And is it a slow process? I mean, how long does it take to create?
Puppet takes 2 or 3 weeks to make.
Per puppet?
Mm-hmm.
All right, so the whole
then, movie. Then the film itself, if we are lucky, we are creating 6 seconds per day.
All right, but the whole film, how long did it take to make the film?
If I'm calculating even the script writing and editing and post-production, it took 1 year.
1 year?
Yes.
Bueno, ella me está diciendo que tiene un equipo internacional para los puppets, ¿no? Para la animación, que es una animación en stop motion. Y se hace a mano. Todo se hace a mano y se pinta a mano. Incluso el esqueleto, el torero inmortal, que es un esqueleto, está hecho de metal. Dice que para cada puppet se invierten alrededor de 2 o 3 semanas. Y finalmente, pues para hacer toda la película, tomó alrededor de 1 año. O sea que es un proceso relativamente lento. Y eso sí, me ha dicho que es como en una película. El costume designer es como si haría una película de ficción. Normal. This is your 20th film. I mean, you are in animation. You are a reference. You know, as a reference in European animation, as advice, what would you say to those people, to young people who are starting in animation?
I would like to say to them that try also the stop motion. We had some kind of a generation gap. Stop motion was very popular still in the 80s when I went to Prague in the 90s. But then after the millennium, it was this computer era. But now stop motion is coming back. And I would like to say to the young generations, try your hands also on stop motion. Try to do something with simple things, not specially with puppets, but objects. Try to find the secret soul of everyday objects and animate them, because it's also a very good lesson.
All right. Well, she says that I'm mixing Spanish and English, you know, it's a mess. Está diciendo que básicamente que durante un tiempo la animación en stop motion, digamos, como que sufrió un parón, pero que alegremente está volviendo. De nuevo está volviendo y se siente feliz por ello. Entonces, lo que le diría a la gente joven, que es lo que le he preguntado, qué consejos le daría a la gente más joven que empieza en animación y quiere hacer stop motion, es que intente dar alma a los objetos, que se fijen en los objetos simples y les intente dar alma. Es básicamente lo más importante que hay que hacer. After this film, are you already working in a new short film? That will be your 21st short film.
Yes, actually, it will be a series of animated films. I'm going to continue the Roma stories. So we are going to create a series of 6 Roma stories.
All right. So, sí, está creando una serie de cortos. O sea, que ella se mantiene, después de 20 cortos, sería 21 que crearía una auténtica veterana de la animación en Europa. Okay, Katarina, we're going to stop here the interview. I want to say thank you very much for having me here to explain some points about you and your film to the public in Aguilar de Campo in Aguilar Film Festival.
So I wish you a very nice festival and hope to see you next time in person.
Yeah, we would like next time. Okay, y a los demás, pues eso, sigan viendo las entrevistas de los demás directores. Y en hay que ver las películas en el cine, en Aguilar de Campo, en el Aguilar Film Festival. Así que un saludo a todos.